The NFL season has hit high gear, and off we go in Week 11 on EA Sports. Gets fielded in the end zone, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So here comes the Packers offense now onto the field, and they'll be led out by the guy under center, Charles, their quarterback. He'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. A gain of three, second down. And the Buffet Boys, the O-line, hopefully they're ready today.
Listen, you got to feed them first. But if you do, you usually get a great product out on the field. And when they play well, the quarterback can't wait to feed them afterwards.
Second down following the run. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And an alley to run. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only are they controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third level. You know, get to the linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. Carter, your thoughts on this D-line?
I love a unit that can control the run and get after the passer. This is an all-around terrific defensive front. Hard to move the ball against them on the ground, and then when you want to throw it, look out. Here they come after the quarterback.
The option going left on second down. And he probably should have given that one off as he's going to get hit and taken down behind the line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that'll bring up a third and 11 situation. He'll look to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Ronald Darby. And they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line. Maybe he telegraphed it a little bit right. That he's going against a rookie quarterback. He stepped in and picked him.
You think he had a great week of preparation, looking forward to this opportunity? And the second part of that is, when you're a young quarterback, you are going to stare down targets, but oftentimes your playbook hasn't expanded to give you full field reads as well. Makes it a little bit tougher for him.
Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it, because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. A handoff as they run the counter play. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and they're left with a third and eight. He had a great read there from his free safety position. Charles, you know with those guys, it's all about their eyes. They have to be laser focused.
Yeah, I had to fake my way through it when I was playing, but now I can see exactly what they're doing. And on that play, he obviously had no presence to feel like he's being pushed for a pass. And without that, that allowed him to get up to the line of scrimmage and hold him to no gain.
On fourth down, here's Sam Martin on to kick it away. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And he couldn't get it to check up. That kicks all the way into the end zone for a touchback. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And still a lot of football to be played in this season. We're only in November. A lot can happen between now and January. But if it ended today, they would just be on the outside of the playoff picture looking in. So a lot to fight for.
Yeah, and wasn't it interesting in our meeting with the coaching staff that they all made sure to let us know, we know where we are right now, but the playoffs don't start tomorrow. We still got some time, and they plan on putting it together formulating a streak. Got the whole month of December still left to play. They think they can get in.
And they made it very obvious to us that there's no playoff talk in the locker room right now. It's win this game and look to next week.
Excellent focus.
And they'll get him down here at the 23. Give him three on the play. And just like that, it's third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Back to throw. And incomplete here on third down.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Team on now as this one sent away. Taken in at the 22. Might have been one man away from 6 points. As it stands, it's a huge return. And this offense is going to be set up with a first and 10 inside the 15. Tevin Coleman. And oh, his first carry, he loses the football. But I believe a Lion was there to recover it. Yes, they will indeed keep possession.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. And a hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
Coverage was very good that time. A nice job to smother him as the ball arrived, and that ensured an incomplete pass.
And it keeps 6 points off the board. And he can't quite intercept it. Zone coverage, free safety was there. Couldn't come up with it, and now it's fourth down.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring up fourth. So he splits the uprights there, and I would imagine it's nice as a kicker. Right when it leaves your foot, you know it's good.
Yeah, it's kind of like a golfer that picks up his tee after a nice drive without even watching it land.
Solid analogy. I like it. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And it's been a rocky start for them thus far. They had the turnover and then the punt on those first two drives.
So there is optimism because they've improved, right? Turnover, you just noted it.
Punt's better than the turnover.
The punt is better on the second one. Now they're hoping to turn into first downs and hopefully points.
The counter now on first down. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. And a nice carry there of 15 yards. Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down.
Here we go now.
They'll run the option right here on first down. And holding it may be the wrong decision as he stopped in the backfield. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And it'll bring up a 2nd and 13. Clock running, under a minute to go now here in a fast-moving first quarter. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Ronald Darby. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Lions touchdown. Now remember, this is the number one defense in the National Football League. There's a good example of why.
Shows that they set an aggressive tone, not just stopping the run, not just getting after the quarterback. But the ball's in the air. They treat it like they're the receivers. And they went after that one and took it all the way.
Extra point attempt to follow here. It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. Defense showing blitz. They'll run it now out of the gun. It's a loss of five there, bringing up second.
Well, forget about finding a lane there. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Probably fortunate he was able to hold on to the football.
Hurry up, here we go. Green.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Shepard. 30. And it's a big play there as he is finally taken down on what will be a terrific final act of this first quarter. Down, he'll drop to throw it. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. It'll be a gain of four, and that'll make it a second down.
I know it was a gain, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there, because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield, you're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held it to an okay game.
And he'll get it down this time to the 17. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
They'll look to throw here. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
I think that was a good job there defensively. They did allow him to drive all the way downfield, but once they got their backs to the goal line, they really turned up the pressure.
Yeah, they let him get all the way down here. Now the field shrinks. They've struggled to convert, and that last incompletion brings up fourth. And his kick is good. And they get themselves on the board here. It's 10-3. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point. So no problems converting there.
This is taken at his four. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. Here's the Lion offense now as they get ready to take over. And, you know, certainly a lot of football left to be played. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're first place in their division, looking good, looking to be a threat come January.
And let's think about what every team has in their goals, all right? Number one goal is what? Make the playoffs. Number two goal is win your division. Number three goal, and the biggest goal, I think, is to be the highest seed possible that you can be heading into the playoffs so that you can have as many home games as possible to try and get you to the Super Bowl.
And right now, fighting for every win possible to try to at least secure home field for the wild card and or divisional round. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time, make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
And he'll be brought down at about the 42. Just a couple there on the second down run. Now they're staring at a 3rd-and-8 situation.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
And they get 14 yards there and a first down. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to run.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 14. And this one will be brought back to the 22.
This is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
Hurry up, here we go.
Now they try the right side here. Slipped one tackle, but no more as he's knocked to the deck behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Partner, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen, we have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle. They were trying to get it there to Sterling Shepard, and that takes us from second to third down.
One thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. They'll leave it for Montgomery complete. The ball comes out, but this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same.
Now I have to admit, partner, that I've often thought that I don't like this rule where the offensive player fumbles the ball, it goes out of bounds, and they're getting to keep it.
That's just because you're a defensive guy. That's why you don't like it.
Yeah, you're right. It is a slanted view, isn't it?
But this is where, for the offensive team, the side. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Jared Davis leading the surge there. He drops him for a loss of six.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. He's going to dump that off to his running back, Montgomery. And now the Lions going to stop us momentarily as they call a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. On now is the Packers punter. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. Now a high kick, almost a pooch punt. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. It's just a 30-yard punt that time, no return. And the Lions will take over. Now we get a peek at the captain of this offense heading back out there. He has not had the start to this game that he envisions here in the second quarter. He's struggling a little bit. But, hey, they're in the lead right now. So kind of what's going on in his head, do you think, Charles?
I think that's what he has to keep in mind. Winning the ball game is not going the way he wants in terms of his own play. But, oh, yeah, that's right, winning the ball game. So don't press. Don't try and do things outside of what's going on right now. Don't try to increase your game or get yourself right. Just make sure you continue to lead your ball club and keep them moving in the right direction.
Well, they've got that lead so far. One interception for him, no touchdown passes. They'll look to throw now on first down. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. It's a gain of 9 yards, and it'll be second and about a yard.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. A good pickup there of 20 yards. Well, this is how you shape the thoughts of that interception on the last drive. You come out and start this one 4-for-4.
And watching him throw it around with that type of confidence reminds me of a guy I played with way back when who told me, I don't care if I throw 10 interceptions.
And he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown. Tevin Coleman, his second touchdown on the season. And the Lions add on to their lead. And that'll give them a two-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here in the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned they're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big decision here.
They'll look to throw. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. And now prior to this third and one, we're going to get a timeout here as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. They'll set up a throw. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. It's a gain of three, and it gets him the first. First down now, but the clock continues to move. They'll look to throw here on first down. And this is Shepard on the catch. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. A gain of six there on first. They'll look to throw again. It's complete to Laquon Treadwell. And he's brought down. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. So we've reached halftime, and never mind, Larry. These two teams apparently anxious to get back at it. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take this across the 25, couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Lions offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? I mean, they score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, I bet you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
Being chased out left, and he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. He'll wind up getting four there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
He's got his man. It's Williams. And they're able to convert on third with a solid gain of 23. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down. So statistically, both of these offenses having a rough time getting a running game going. But boy, what a nice play there defensively.
Tackling him behind the line, but you're right, you look at the numbers. Neither side looks on track in the ground game. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
And you just know, when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
On the screen, Bernard. Pass the 20. Touchdown, Detroit. Giovanni Bernard, his first touchdown on the year. And the Lions are able to grow their lead. Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit. Get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, being on second half, no matter what. Well, it's first 5 minutes, first three, whatever. This was a big score to start the second half.
So here are the Packers now. They get set for their first possession of half number two. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here at half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, to something to get you off to a quick start.
On second down, they'll try and run the counter. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. It'll be a loss of one, and that'll make it third down.
If these guys are going to chop into that deficit, they got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage will be found.
They're set up to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
We're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. This is brought in at the 21. Gets past one man. Oh, and now he bowls him over. A nice job on the return there. 16 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. Here again comes the captain of this offense leading his crew back out there now. How do you think he personally is evaluating his game so far? He was pretty good in the first half, been good so far here in the third quarter. He's got to like it, right?
Not looking for the dramatics here. Not trying to set the world on fire in terms of stats. It's almost like you're driving. Hands at 10-2, alert for anything out there, watching for trouble on the road, and making sure you get the team home.
The bus driver. See if he can drive the bus here again on this drive. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
And they pick up 25 as they convert on third.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one. And that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Give them 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. Fresh set of downs here.
Back it up, Billy. Here we go.
They're going to look to throw. And a quick throw here. That's complete. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. A gain of 6 there on first. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down.
Let's go! 3-19! 3-19!
They'll run it now, out of the gun. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what'll be a 3rd and 4. Wasn't able to get anything, no gain. Fumbled once already. Maybe he's being a little careful. Not necessarily on that play, but I'm sure that's in his mind somewhere.
Oh, without a doubt, because protecting the football is job one for anyone who's carrying it, and that's exactly what he tried to do on that play, but it didn't gain him any yardage.
Out of the gun now on third down. And that is caught. Oh, what a catch at the 5-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
The catch, deservedly so, is going to get a lot of credit, but even more so because there's a defender there ready to make a play.
Yeah, just flat out muscled on that one. And they will not have time to get another play in here as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. back now at Ford Field. Five yards to go for the offense. First down and goal from that five-yard line.
All right, here we go.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the one. Give him four on the carry there. It's second and goal. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. They're still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning, right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
A 10-play drive that time, and it's capped off by a touchdown for the Lions. Martin, the punter, now out to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Packer offense now ready to get back onto the field. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. And oh, he coughed it up. And this is scooped up by the Lions.
You and I have been around teams, and they all have goals for games, don't they? And every team we've ever talked to says what?
No turnover.
Don't turn the ball over. Zero. And they were that close to getting it done. Won't cost them today, but they'll hate that when they're watching the game tape.
Throw left side complete. It's Shepard. A gain of six there on first. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
He'll look to throw. Oh, nearly picked. And maybe lucky there. This guy doesn't drop many defensively. Third down. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better and better.
Finds his target, Montgomery. And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48. Call it a gain of seven, and it gets him a new set of downs. And the defense definitely showing blitz here. They'll drop to throw. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Danielle Hunter, he's the one to get him, and that's sack number seven for him on the year. A rookie QB struggling, gets thrown down to the ground there. But, you know, maybe this game, it's not over yet, but maybe this game can be a learning experience for him.
So many different things that he has to pick up on. When to go ahead and flush from the pocket and run. When to get rid of the football and not take the sack. When to just go ahead and go down early and make sure you don't fumble the football. So many things that he has to learn. This game starts the process. When you're putting together a formula for winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offense's backfield. They're playing an excellent game.
And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. They do get nine, but it leads to fourth down.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
And now a high kick here as he'll try to hang it up there. That'll go as a punt of 32 yards. And the Lions are going to take over with a long field ahead and a first and 10. Here's the Detroit offense now as they head back out onto the field. There have been no struggles here for this crew. I mean, they were up double digits at halftime, and they've just expanded that here in the second half.
and it appears there are no answers from the defensive side. I think right now, if I'm the coordinator, if I'm down on the field, if I'm wearing a hat, I've already thrown it. If it's a visor, it's sailed, right? My game plan is down by my feet right now because nothing I've drawn up appears to be working.
Well, he's going to have to find something right now to stop this offense. That one goes for 24 yards.
When you have someone throwing it that well, that confidently, you don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
Yeah, you don't have to tuck your head in and look like turtle at this point. You can just go ahead and play.
And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
In motion left goes a tight end. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Well, at least he was able to break that initial contact, or it could have been a loss.
Yeah, give credit to the defensive player, though. What did he do? Made him slow down, slow up his feet, and allowed the rest of the guys to get there to finish him off.
Now it looks like he'll throw here. Packer pressure, and down he goes. Fletcher Cox in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year. He didn't get rid of the football there, took the sack, although that's easier said than done. He can't just chuck the thing sideways into the seats.
No, he really can't, because you're not afforded total protection as a quarterback. You have to get outside of the tackle boxes as defined by the NFL, meaning wherever your tackles operate normally, get outside of that. And the ball that you throw has to get back to at least the line of scrimmage. Otherwise, you face an intentional grounding call. Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
Now a play fake here on first down. Ebron with it over the middle. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense, and reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there that sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. They go play action here on first down. And nearly picked off there, almost intercepted. Instead, second down. He's lucky to be getting that one back.
After what they've done with him all day long with all the targets trying to go after him, he's obviously gotten smart and his pride has kicked in. Made a terrific play.
Back to throw now on second and 10. And that is incomplete. So 17 seconds now on the clock here. Eric Ebron, the big tight end, his intended target. And it's third down. This drive, which was going so smoothly, all of a sudden it's a little bit of a roadblock here with two straight incompletions.
Yeah, apparently this defense has had enough. Apparently they're saying no more. We're taking a stand right here, right now. But it is third and 10. They've got to get after him one more time.
He'll drop to throw. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Now this will be the ninth play on this drive.
Double tight, guys, double tight.
A handoff as they run the counter play. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
Is it okay if I break one of our rules, partner, which is to never call a game over until it's over? Because this certainly...
Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. Martin, the punter, now out to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Throwing here on first down. He's going to let it fly. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game. And Charles, you know what coaches always tell us. We want to win our home games. That much we know. We want to protect our home turf. They got that done in this one.
Exactly right. When you start a season, everyone's goal. Win all of your home games, split your road games, and you're likely going to be in the playoffs. But when you win at home, boy, what a great feeling that is. You don't even mind if people are at your house when you get home after a win like that.
So for the Lions, the great run they've been on continues as they move to 9-1 now. And now they'll have the short week ahead as they'll host their annual Thanksgiving Day game on Thursday. Meanwhile, for Green Bay, it was a game they really needed as they drop back to 4-6. And they will be at home next week to take on the New York Giants. So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. It's a win for the Lions as we say so long from Ford Field.